So let me introduce about myself. My name is Rajashekhar and I'm a maths teacher. I'm going to handle maths for this week. And first chapter is number system. Everyone, please take your notebook and consider that it is your regular foundation classes, which will have, you know, how it will be, you know, will be happening in our Baba Towers or in other places, in Neyveli also. In other places, how regularly it will happen, consider like this and then start to listen the classes properly the next 1 hour. So I'll engage with you and you have to take the proper notes at the end of the session. I will give you homeworks also. You have to finish off the homework and next week you have to clarify the doubt also relates to that. And let me start my session today. Today's topic is number system. This is the basic topic in all the classes. You have already studied about the types of numbers and different types of numbers and some examples relates to that, fractions, prime factors, etc., etc. I'm just going to give you a small recap about this number system and we will go to the exercise questions after we finish off the basics. Number system. So in the number system, we can draw a small flow chart. That flow chart is real numbers. Let us consider this is the top class number, real numbers. Under this real numbers, we have two type of numbers. Rational number and irrational number. These rational numbers and irrational numbers you will study detailedly about in your 8th and 9th standard about this. Next one, under these rational numbers, we can divide this part into three. One is integers, another one is natural numbers, and the next one is whole numbers. So this is a very small flow chart about real numbers. Under real numbers, we have two different type of numbers. One is a rational number and another one is irrational numbers. Regarding rational numbers and irrational numbers, you will study about it very detailedly in your 8th and 9th standard. Under these rational numbers, we have three different type of numbers. One is integers and the second one is natural numbers and third one is whole numbers. So in your 7th standard, we are going to discuss about these three numbers, integers, natural numbers and the whole numbers. Please draw a chart in your notebook. I'll give you 30 seconds time.
हेलो सर,
Now, we will discuss about rational numbers and irrational numbers later, and I'm going to explain what is natural numbers. Most of you students knows about it. What is natural numbers? What is the definition of natural numbers? Because in different books, different definitions will be there. So let me say a very basic definition of natural numbers. Natural numbers are simply called as countable numbers. All countable numbers are called natural numbers. Example: 3, 4, 5, etc., etc. So, what is the meaning of all countable numbers? Suppose I'm asking you a simple question. How many school bags do you have? What will be your reply? I have one school book. Some students may have more school bag or school books, and they will say the answers are I have one school book, school bag, and somebody will say I have three school bag. One is in my school and another two is in my home. Okay, so your answers will be 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Will you say I have 1.3 school bags? Will you say I have 4.7 notebooks? No, it is not at all possible to say the answer is 4.7 notebooks, because we can't count that 4.7, but we can count 4. We can count 5 tables, 5 chairs. We can count 8 books, etc., etc. So that's why we are saying all countable numbers are called natural numbers. Okay, yes, hope you understood the definition of natural numbers. And second one is whole numbers. Whole numbers. What is the definition of the whole numbers? All countable numbers along with the zero is called whole numbers. So whole numbers, it will start with a 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., etc. And what about natural numbers? What is the first natural number? The first as well as minimum natural number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. It will go on till the infinity. Okay. Now, what is the difference between natural numbers and whole numbers? Only one number is differ from natural number, so that number is 0. So in natural numbers, 0 will not be included, but in whole numbers, 0 will be included. Okay. I want to ask you a small question. Think about that question yourself and then write the answer in your notebook. So please copy this. Let me give you 30 seconds. After that, I will ask you a question. Hope everyone copy this definition of natural numbers and whole numbers. I'm just going to rub the book. If someone is not copied, please send me a message to Chidambaram sir. He is the host. As soon as you send the message, he will communicate to me, and then I will keep wait for you to complete it. So I'm assured that this session will be more interesting. Why? Because I'm not going to teach only all mathematics numbers. In between, I will teach you some tricks related to mathematics also. So it will be more interesting for you to work out the problems. Okay, good. And I have a small question in my mind. That small question is, all natural numbers are whole numbers. True or false? And second question, all whole numbers are natural numbers. True or false? Take few seconds to find the answer for these two questions. After that, I will explain it. Question number one, all natural numbers are whole numbers. You have to say whether that is true or false. And second one, all whole numbers are natural numbers. You have to say whether it is true or false. Hope you have all completed the answer for these two questions. Check whether your answer is right or wrong. The answer for the first question is true. The answer for the second question is false. How? All natural numbers are whole numbers. Correct? All natural numbers are whole numbers. Yes, because natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc. Whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc. See here, all natural numbers. Here one is the smallest natural number, and this one is also there in whole number. 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is there. And all the numbers which is there in the natural numbers will be there in the whole numbers also. That's why we can say confidently all natural numbers are whole numbers. Hope you understood. And next one, all whole numbers are natural numbers. See here, all whole numbers except 0 is there in the natural numbers. See here, 0 is the extra number which is not there in natural numbers. So remaining all the numbers in the whole numbers will be there in the natural numbers also. Even though all numbers except 0 is there in the natural number, we should not say all whole numbers are natural numbers, because one number in whole number, 0 is not there in the natural number. So that's why all whole numbers are natural numbers is the false statement. Why? Because 0 is included in the whole number, but it is not there in the natural number. So I think I made the clear explanation of these two questions. It's a time to move to the next type of numbers. Okay, and the next one is integers. What is integers? Everyone knows about this integers very well because you might have been studied about this basics in your sixth standard. Suppose if you draw a number line. Okay, and this is the number 0, and the right side of the 0, all the numbers will be positive, and the left side of the numbers will be in negative form. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, etc, etc. So all the numbers which are there in the number line is called as integers. Or else you can say in another way of the definition, the numbers, all natural numbers which are in the positive sign as well as negative sign is called as integers. Okay, now let's write the definition of this. All natural numbers including 0 is called so you may ask a question to me, sir, 0 is a positive number or negative number? 0 is either positive nor negative. 0 is neither positive nor negative, but it is also will include in the integers. So that is a separate part. I'll explain to you later. So write the definition of this. All natural numbers which are in positive and negative sign, including 0, is called integers. Example, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 4, 7, 8, etc., etc. Okay, hope everyone copied this. Now I want to ask you few more questions based on the three different numbers so far we have studied: natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. I'm going to rub the board now. Question number 1. All natural numbers are integers. Say whether it is true or false. And second one, all integers are whole numbers. For this question also, say true or false. All integers are whole numbers. Here all natural numbers are integers. Take 30 seconds time and then start to find out the answer for both questions. And I hope most of you know the answer for these two questions and check your answer whether it is right or wrong after I explain that. It's the time to discuss the answer for these two questions. Number one, all natural numbers are integers. Exactly, this answer is true. Why? Because natural numbers starts with 1 and continue with 2, 3, 4, etc., etc., up to infinity. Okay. And our integer also, if you draw a number line, you will come to know that 0 will be there, 1 will be there, 2 will be there, 3 will be there, 4 will be there, etc., etc. This side -1, -2, -3, all negative numbers will be there in this side. Now, dear students, I want to ask you one question, and you have to say that is right or wrong. Think by yourself and say the answer. 1 is there in natural numbers as well as there in integers. 2 is there in natural number as well as in integers. So then I can say all numbers in natural numbers are there in integers. Okay, it starts with 1, here also 1 is there. So if it ends with infinity, means here also with integer, it will end with infinity. Got it? So the answer for this question, all natural numbers are integer, is the true statement. This is true. Second one, all integers are whole numbers. All integers are whole numbers. This is an integers. Let me write whole numbers. Whole numbers 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc. This is whole numbers. This is natural numbers. Now, tell me the answer for this question is true or false. The answer for this question is false, because in integers we have negative numbers, but in our whole numbers we don't have any negative numbers. So as soon as you see the question, you can say the answer for this question is false, because all the numbers which are there in integer is not there in whole numbers, but all whole numbers are integers. That statement is true, but all integers are whole numbers. This statement is false. Hope you understood the definition of the two questions. Let's we move to the next topic. Okay. I want to ask you a small question. You have to say the answer within 5 to 6 seconds. Okay, so you are not able to say the answer to me, that I understood well, but write the answer in the notebook and check whether your answer is right or not. 321 into 999. Okay. So I want to find out the answer for this question, but you should not take more than 5 seconds to find out the answer for this question. Okay. So let's see how many of you will find out. Be honest. At least you take 30 seconds to find out the answer for the question. Okay. Don't take more than 30 seconds to find the answer for the question. So your 30 seconds time is over. The answer for this question is 320679. Am I right? Yes. How? Let's recheck this answer in a normal multiplication method. 321 into 999. 1 9 is 9, 2 9 is 18. Carry over 1, 27, 28. And here also 9, 8, 8, 2 will come. And here also 9, 8, 8, 2 will come. So we have to add up this. Here 9 will come, 8 plus 9 17, so write 7 here, carry over 1, 9 9 plus 8 17 17 plus 9 26, 6 carry over 2, 8 plus 2 10, again 8 plus 2 20, 0 carry over 2, 8 plus 2 10, and this is 12, 1 carry over 1. The answer for this question is 320679. Okay, so this I have done in your normal multiplication method. And do you know how did I find out the answer for this question within 5 seconds? It is very easy. This is your shortcut to find out the multiplication of any numbers with 999 or 9899, etc., etc. Okay, but before we start to find out the answer for this question, ensure that the number of digits in the two different numbers are same or different. Now here also a three digit number, and here also it is a three digit number. This is also a three digit number, and this is also a three digit number. First, what you have to do, see the number 321. You need not to take this number because this number is 999. So this is the hint for our question. We have to take the numbers which is not including with 9 or 9s. 321. Okay. Now 321. First subtract. One from 321. If you subtract one from 321, you will get 320. Okay. Now here we have three digits, and here also we have three digits, and we already wrote three digits here. Put three dashes. We have to fill the dash over here. It's a very interesting thing. How we are going to fill these three dashes? Okay, now this number is 3. With the 3, which number you will add means you will get the answer as 9. 3 plus which number is equal to 9. Obviously, your number is 6. Write that number 6 over here. Similarly, take 2. 2 plus which number is equal to 9. 2 plus 7 is equal to 9. So fill up that number 7 here. And the next, this number is 0. 0 plus which number is equal to 9. 0 plus 9 is equal to 9. So I have to fill this number as 9. So you can say the answer very easily for this question. 321 into 999 is equal to 320679. So once again, I repeat this method and try to understand very properly. The students who didn't understand in the first time explanation. First, we have to check the given numbers are having the same number of digits. This number and this number is the given numbers. Here, three digit number is there, and here also three digit number is there. Okay, now we have to go to the next step. Subtract 1 from 321, we get 320. Then we have to start from the left side. What is the first number here? 3. With the 3, which number you will add up means you will get 9, 6. You write that number 6 here. With which number you will add 2 means you will get 9 as your answer, 7. Which number if you will add up with 0 means you will get 9 as your answer, 9 is the answer. So 320679 is your right answer for this question. Hope you understood this explanation well. So let me give you 2 practice questions and start to find out the answer. Don't take more than 15 seconds to find out the answer. And if you need, I am ready to explain another one example also. I think somebody didn't copy this, so please copy that one. Okay, hope everyone copied this. 2 questions. 27 into 99. Here the number of digit is 2. Here also the number of digits is 2. Now, first step. Step number 1. Subtract 1 from 27. Then 27 minus 1 is equal to 26. Write 26 here and put 2 dashes. 2 plus which number is equal to 9. 2 plus 7. 7 write it here. 6 plus which number you will get the answer is 9. So here 3. So answer for this question is 2673. And take these two questions and find out the answer. 218 into 999 and 47 into 99. So this is for your DIY. So DIY means do it yourself. 218 into 999, 47 into 99. So you take these two questions and later you try to find out the answer by using the shortcut method. Good. Let me give you 15 seconds time. Please copy this. And everyone, please don't forget to take the notes, because we will ask you to send the notes to us anytime. You have to be prepared for it. Don't consider that this is online class, so we need not to show that much kind of seriousness towards it. Okay, so don't think like that, because this is your foundation class. This is a very basic foundation classes for you. You have to start your initiation in the beginning itself very properly. You have to be eager to learn something. Okay, so let me wrap this. So let's we continue our types of numbers. Now we have discussed about natural numbers. Second one is whole numbers, and third one is integers. So in integers we have two different parts. Positive integers and negative integers. Positive integers and negative integers. See here, what is the symbol of these numbers? Symbol of set of these numbers. Set of these numbers, natural numbers 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. So this is a symbol for infinity. So this set of all natural numbers are represented by the symbol N. The set of all natural numbers are represented by the symbol N. And set of all whole numbers are represented by the symbol W. And set of all integers are represented by the symbol dash. Integers are represented by the symbol Z. And positive integers are represented by the symbol Z plus, and negative integers are represented by the symbol Z minus. Here all are capital letters. N is a capital letters and W is a capital letters and Z, Z plus and Z minus. Please note it down. So these are all the symbols of set of these numbers. Set of all natural numbers. What is the meaning of set? 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. This is one set. Set of all natural numbers. Whole numbers, it will start with 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. Then integers. Integers, you know about what is positive integers and what is negative integers. Including all, we will say simply Z is the symbol for integers. For positive integers, that is Z plus, and for negative integers, that is Z minus. So today is our introduction class. That's why I didn't discuss all the topics and all the concepts which is there in the first chapter. So let's we discuss very slowly and very properly. Okay, so dear students, we are going to discuss about face value and place value. So you know the difference between face value and place value, because this topic is already there in your sixth standard number system. That means first chapter, knowing our numbers. Anyhow, let it be a small recap about it and think about yourself whether you understood the concept very clearly in your sixth standard or not. Face value and place value. Suppose I have a number 748. Okay. So here, what is the face value of 4? And what is the place value of 4? So you write these two questions and start to find the answer. Then after I explain it and check whether it is right or not. Okay, students, it's the time to discuss our answer. Face value of 4. The meaning of face value is very simple. The same number. So, face value of 4 is 4 only. What is the place value of 4? What is the meaning of place value? In which place that number is there. Okay, here this is ones place, and what about this one? This is tens place. So in the tens place, our number is 4. Then our place value of 4 is 40. So our place value of 4 is equal to what? 40. Then what is the place value of 7? The place value of 7 is 700. Place value of 7 is equal to 700. So to find out the place value of any number, we have to see that particular number is in which place. Which place means whether it is in ones place or tens place or hundred place or thousands place or 10,000 place or lakhs place, etc., etc., etc. So after we find out the exact number of place which it is available, we have to multiply that place with that particular number. See here, this is in 100th place. That's why we multiply 7 into 100. So our answer is 700. So our 4 is in 10th place. So that's why we multiplied this 4 with 10. Our answer is 40. Hope my explanation is very clear for you all. Okay. So we have discussed about face value and place value just now, and let's go to the prime factorization and square root. So if we see what is prime factorization. Number one, prime factorization. What is the prime factorization of 56? Prime factorization of 56. How will you find out the prime factorization? This is your lower class concept, 56. Let us take our prime number 2. Then this is called L method. 2 to sub 4, remainder 1, A to sub 16. Again, we can divide this number by 2. 1 2 is 2, 4 2 are 8. Again, we can divide this number by 2, 7 2 are 14. Further, it is not possible to divide by any number. Why? Because 7 is prime number, so we can divide only by 7. So we can write our 56 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 7. And you should not include this 1 in the prime factors. That is very important. Don't include the number 1 in the prime factorization. Okay, so again we can write this is 56 is equal to 2 power 3 into 7. So you may understand why I wrote 2 power 3 over here, because we multiplied 2 in 3 times. That's why I put the power as 3. So you will study about this one very detailed in your 8th standard. 56 is equal to 2 power 3 into 7. 7 power 1. If you want to write 7 power 1, you can write it. Or else you can leave simply. That is understand. Okay. This is prime factorization. Now, I think we are in the last 5 minutes. I just want to know about your queries and I want to resolve it. Chidambaram sir? Chidambaram sir? Chidambaram sir, are you available?
Yes sir, tell me.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, I think we are in the last 5 minutes, and I just want to know the doubts of the students.
Okay.
Is there
Students,
any question?
you can raise your hand if you have any doubts.
Sorry, sir.
No, I'm telling the students.
Okay.
You can raise your hand if you have doubts, or you can come to chat and ask your doubts. Any doubts, students? Okay, Selva. Selva always has doubts. Okay, yeah, you tell me now. I have unmuted you, Selva. You can ask the doubts. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, that shortcut 999 somehow, sir.
Yes.
That can be only used for nine. Only for nine. That like.
Nine. Yes.
Nine.
999, etc., etc. Okay. And today I explained only the same number of digits. And next class I will explain if the number of digits are different. Suppose 77 into 999. In this case, here we have 2-digit numbers and here we have 3-digit numbers. Okay, so in this case, how will you find out the answer? Very simple. Put 0 before this 077 and 999. Nothing is wrong in this. Why? Because we just added up 0 before this number. So this 0 will never change the value 77. Now, again, we have to subtract 1. Step number 1, 076. Step number 1, 076. Again, this will not make any change in our original number. That is 77 minus 1, 76. I just put 0 before this. Now put 3 dashes. We have to consider this also one digit. 3 dashes. Start it from here. 0 plus which number is equal to 9? 9. 7 plus which number is equal to 9? 2. 6 plus which number is equal to 9? 3. So your answer is 76,923. So this is another one model if the number of digits are not same. Do you understand clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Any other student? Don't click on start video. Please raise your hand alone. I will be able to unmute you.
Sir, I want to share few homeworks to the students. It is like a photo in my mobile. Shall I share it to you?
Yes, sir, you can do, sir.
Yes, any students are asking doubts, sir? Any students? Any
yes, sir. No doubt.
Okay, so let me share one homework questions to the students. Let them copy it. After that, we will wind up the session, sir. Hardly it will take 3 minutes to copy the entire questions. Is it okay, sir?
Yeah, yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yes. dear students, here 5 questions are there in the share screen. You take only first 3 questions. You need not to do 4th question and the 5th question. Take question number 1, 2 and 3 and solve that 3 questions. This is your homework for the next week. No need to take 4th and 5th questions because I didn't discuss that model still. 1. 2 and 3. These 3 questions are easy. And first question, just before I discussed to you, model. First question model. And the second question is very simple question. You have studied in your lower classes. You apply that knowledge and try to get the answer. Question number 3 is also similar to question number 2. Hope you will all do that 3 questions. So everyone must to complete it. I will check your homework on next week. I will ask you to send the answers for the homeworks. So get ready for that also. Don't think that for the namesake we have given the homework. So we will be keep on following that. சோ எல்லாரும் ஹோம்வொர்க் பண்ணிரணும் மூணு பேர் மூணு சமயம் மறந்துடாதீங்க
ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் யூ கேன் டேக் எ ஸ்கிரீன்ஷாட் ஆஃப் திஸ்
ஆ எஸ் தட் இஸ் பெட்டர் பட் whether they know about it sir to take the screenshot
in mobile they will be able to know it
okay
in laptop there is a print screen option click on it and then paste it in the MS Word okay so that you will be able to save it
so SMAS means the abbreviation of SMAS 1.1 seventh max assignment sheet seventh max assignment sheet
Students, please respond if you have completed copying the question, or you can take the screenshot. If you have completed it, please tell me in chat.
They can raise up their hands, right, sir?
Yeah, but only for doubt. But for this, if they have done it, you can just come to chat and say done.
Completed. Okay.
Or anybody needs time, they can come to chat and say I need time.
Oh, I understood. Sir, how was the video clarity and voice?
Hello, good.
Is it okay?
It was good.
Okay.
Okay, students, do you need some more time? If you need time, please come to chat and say.
So don't take all five postings, take only first three postings.